Hey everyone, Vinayak here. In an earlier video, I had shown steps to make your own 3D bust or 3D selfie as some call it. I had a Kinect lying around and hence I could make the video. But if you don't have one, how do you still make your own 3D scans? Watch on to find out. The Kinect is a specialized piece of hardware that users of an Xbox might have access to, and actual 3D scanners are way out of our budget. But today, we're going to scan objects using a device which most of us have at our disposal, a mobile phone. The technique we're going to use is called photogrammetry. Photogrammetry is not a new technology in any which way, and it appeared in the middle of 19th century, almost simultaneously with the appearance of photography itself. With digital photography becoming more accessible to everyone, photogrammetry just needed a camera, which could also be a mobile camera, and you would also need a moderately powerful PC. So how do we digitize the real world? First, we need to select a model. This should do. I've chosen this model as it's small enough to work with and move around to get the necessary pictures for the process. Make sure to evenly light the object from all sides so that there are no sudden changes in the colors, and make sure to avoid hard shadows. Taking pictures outside under a cloudy sky will give you more even lighting. Now, using a mobile phone, circle around the object, taking pictures from as many angles as you can. Even move the camera to the top and bottom, or those details will be left out when processing the picture on the computer. You would effectively move in a spherical motion around the object being scanned. Make sure to keep the object in one place and it not move, or the entire process would go to waste. This could happen by physically moving the object or bumping the table by mistake while taking pictures. Capturing as many photos as you can of the object will help bring out the details in the model, and make sure to capture the object from as many angles as you can. 50 to 100 photos might be necessary to get a good enough detail from the images. The more information the software has to work with, the more detailed the model becomes. Make sure the object covers most of the screen, essentially making it stand out. Close-up shots can be taken for finer details. The software would use the surroundings to know the location of the camera, allowing it to build the 3D model using the spatial information. Now that we have the shots, let's move on to the PC to process them. There are n number of software options, but most of them are expensive. But I was lucky to find Meshroom, a free open source 3D reconstruction software which uses the Alice Vision framework. Windows and Linux versions are available, so you can pick whichever flavor you choose. As I'm running Windows, I of course downloaded the Windows 64-bit archive. No Mac version available again, sorry. A CUDA-enabled GPU is recommended with a compute capability of about 2.0. CUDA is a parallel computing platform and programming model that enables dramatic increases in computing performance by harnessing the power of the graphics processing unit, or GPU. The higher the version number, also called SM number, the more CUDA features the GPU supports. Well, that's for a different video, as we are digressing from the main topic. So we have our photographs, now we need to process them. Just unzip the Meshroom archive into a folder and the software is ready to use. Double click on the Meshroom icon and the software starts up. The interface is quite simple. It has a window named Images. You would generally drag and drop the images into this window and hit Start, and Meshroom would start performing its magic. You can see that the object is slowly coming to form. The approximate camera positions are also displayed in the 3D preview. All pictures that have successfully been identified for the reconstruction are tagged with a green mark. Pictures marked in red are discarded images. Meshroom also supports augmented reconstruction, which allows adding in more images to add more details to the constructed model later. So if you feel one side of the object could use more details, or a few in that section have been discarded by the software, photograph them again, import into the software, and add the details to the partially constructed model. But you should have not moved the object from its place, or augmented reconstruction will not work. Meshroom also allows live reconstruction, which generally means you could have a watch folder that Meshroom keeps looking into for new pictures. As in, when you drop pictures into the folder, Meshroom starts processing them automatically. Looking at the preview on the screen, you can decide if you need more detail and which areas don't look as good. Just take some more pictures and drop it into the folder, and Meshroom adds the details. The reconstruction happens step by step, and these are indicated by the nodes below. The entire pipeline, node by node, is explained on the Alice Vision website and in more detail on their wiki page. Reconstruction is not instantaneous and will take some time, hours even, so a lot of patience is expected. The model seems to have come out really well. I used a smartphone in this tutorial as newer smartphones have high enough resolution camera for this task. But if you have a DSLR, the model will come out much better. Even the textures are captured and mapped onto the model. All meshes that are generated will have a hole in the bottom. So you can use Mesh Mixer or Blender or your favorite 3D program to add a plane below to close it up. The object created by Meshroom is a standard 3D wavefront OBJ format and can be imported into your favorite slicer program directly. You might want to do a basic cleanup of the model in Mesh Mixer before slicing it to print. Photogrammetry is used by architectural firms and also post-production studios to have a virtual representation of the area for survey or VFX purposes. Meshroom can handle photos from multiple cameras, which is fantastic. You can also use frames from a video to reconstruct, but due to compression, the details will not stand out as much. But if you had shot an object as a video during a vacation and want to reconstruct it, you can still do it. You might have problems capturing glossy surfaces, so maybe try masking the glossy surface with painter's tape before capture. Even though this can be done by anyone at home, my earlier Kinect method gives much better results in minutes. Photogrammetry takes hours and the end result is okay. Not as great as I expected it to be. Yes, I've not lit the model evenly and the photographs might not have been the best, but I still managed to get a model ready, so I can't blame Meshroom completely. I hope this video gets you interested in photogrammetry, and do try this method out yourself, and if you get better results, do share it in the comments below. If you have any questions, do write into tech@talkingstuff.net or WhatsApp us at 965257883. Make sure to like, subscribe, and also hit the notification bell to be informed when new videos are added. Thank you for watching and see you all next time.